Hello everyone, welcome back to in this new session 2020-21. Let's start our session from first chapter of geography, that is resources and development. But before it, I want to appeal you, it is very critical time for us. You know very well, a plague, epidemic, that is COVID-19. Not only our country, but we can say the whole community of the world is suffering from this disease, COVID-19. So how we can fight with it? Some of the steps to defeat corona. Also, we should concern about it. That is first, don't shake hand to each other. Second one, we should maintain social distancing always. And next one, pay attention for neatness and cleanness in our homes. These are the steps we can fight it. And certainly, I hope that we will get victory and we will defeat COVID-19. Okay, students, let's start our topic. Chapter number first from geography, resources and development. Topic is resources. You know very well, what is the meaning of resource? We are using so many resources in our everyday life, from morning to evening. Not only single resource, but also so many resources we are using from morning to evening, from a little thing to a very big object. Whenever we travel from one place to another, we use transportation, automobile vehicles. These are the resources. Also, in kitchen, from morning to evening, from breakfast to dinner, so many equipment or machines are used in our kitchen. To cook our foods, these are resources. And also, we can make our life easier. So many things, so many machines we are using in our everyday life. Student, I want to introduce with the meaning of resources. It means, what is resource? Resource is a thing or substance which can be used to fulfill the basic needs of human or wants of human. This is called resource. Once again, I want to repeat, any substance, any material or any item which can be used to fulfill our needs or wants, this is called resource. For example, pen, pencil, eraser, books, cloth, garment, bus, car, truck, railway, aeroplane, helicopter, and also a little thing. These are the resources. We will move ahead. The type of resources. In the general concept, we can understand the type of resources. That is first, natural resources, and second one also, human resource. You studied in previous classes the natural resources from 6th and 7th standard, and also you studied human resources. But here, we will classify the resources in different ways. So that is the first way, on the basis of origin. Utpatti ki aadhar. On the basis of origin, that is the first, biotic resource. What is the meaning of biotic? It means all the living things, including flora, fauna, and human beings. All these resources are non-biotic resources. Second one, abiotic resources. Abiotic, it means non-living things. All the non-living things which can be used to fulfill our needs, but it has no life. It is not a biotic resource. For example, land, soil, water, minerals, and grains or cereal crops. These are the abiotic resources. We will move ahead next. That is second, on the basis of exhaustibility. Exhaustibility, it means exploitation. In what way we can exploit the resources? What are the way to exploit the resources? That is first, renewable resources. It means resources which can be renewed. For example, solar energy, wind energy, water, plants or forests. These are the resources can be renewed in short term. And second part of this, that is non-renewable resources. Non-renewable, according to meaning you can understand non-renewable, which cannot be renewed. Jisko hum renew nahi kar sakte hain within a short term, because it takes millions of years. Lakho varsh lagte hain. This part is divided into two parts. That is for recyclable resource. Recyclable resource which can be recycled, like metal work. All the metal we can recycle or remelt, and also we can give new shape or size. This is recycle, and also it is the part of non-renewable. Second is non-recyclable, which cannot be recycled, like coal and petroleum or the fossil fuels. We can't recycle it. Once we used coal and petroleum, after that we can't recycle it. We will move next one. That is the third, on the basis of ownership. It means who is the owner of such property. That is first, individual resources. Individual, it means we know very well all the person, and also we have property, and our parents are owner of the plots, land and houses. If anyone has property, it has its own property, like land, houses, plots. This is individual resources. Second one, community resources. Community, it means community owned resources. Not only a single person, but also these resources can be used by whole community of the village or town, like public places, public parks, playgrounds and other public institutions. In the village area, you can see pasture land area or the grazing land area, is it can be used by the villager. In the village area, you can see ponds, water ponds can be used by the villagers. So this is community owned resources. Next one, see, national resources. National resources are owned by the nation. It can be controlled by the nation or the national government. Also, national government can maintain it, all these resources. Therefore, it is known as national resources. For example, roads, highways, railways, airports, ports, waterways, and other institutions of the government which are used in the interest of public, which are used in the interest of human of the nation. So it is non-national resources. Next one, D, international resources. International, antarrashtri. Not only a single country, it can be used by whole community of the world, all the countries of the world. Like for example, exclusive economic zone. It is the beyond 200 nautical miles from the state or national coastal boundary. It means, you know, from national coast or national land boundary, 22 kilometer, that is 12 nautical miles, are the resources of national resource. But beyond 22 kilometer, when we go further, go ahead into the water bodies, after crossing 12 nautical miles, then it is known exclusive economic zone. It can be used by whole nations of the world. Like, for example, Trans-Indian Ocean route is used for European countries, East Asian countries, Asian countries, African countries. So this is international resources. So many other resources are there, like fisheries. We can use fisheries industries. This is economically very rich, and most of the country are the fishermen. They are using this area. Next one, number 4, on the basis of state of development. Fourth category is on the basis of development. It means in what way we can develop the resources. What is the development status of the resource? That is first, potential. It means what is the potential of the country. How many resources we can develop. What is potential in the northwest country, the coastal region of Gujarat and Rajasthan. We can generate power through solar energy. We can generate wind energy. So much potential, but due to the lack of technology, we are not using. We are not generating wind energy and solar energy on the coastal region of Rajasthan and Gujarat. Second one, developed resources. You know, developed means we have surveyed the resources, what is the quality of resources and quantity of resources, but we are not using, we are not exploiting the resources due to the lack of technology. We left after survey. This is developed resources. And next one, C, stocks. It means after survey, we knew about the quality and quantity of the resources. Then we left because of we have no technology, we have no appropriate technology to exploit these resources. This is known as stocks of the country. Humne chhod diye, stock mein hai. Is tarah ki resource, such type of resources are known stocks. And next one, D, reserved resources. It means we have appropriate technology. We knew about the quality of the resource. We knew about the quantity of the resource. And after that, we left for future requirement of the nation. Nowadays, we are using some of the alternative resources. But we have the resources in our country. Our country's resources. We left. We are not using. And left for future requirements of the nation. These resources are known reserved resources. So thank you, student. And at the end of this session, I want to say once again, take care and stay at home. But you have to complete your written work from this chapter, resources and development, in your fair notebook. It means, I mean to say, you have to make your notes in fair notebook. Okay, thank you.